the October Midsummer Norton Town Council meeting. A couple of things to mention. One, the meeting is being recorded over there. There's no members of public currently in the view of the camera, but if anyone objects to their line is being recorded, then please let us know.
Sorry, councillor, you haven't got a choice.
Councillor, haven't got a choice. The second thing is we're going to bring forward item 6, Youth Connect South West, because we've got Jane and Alec. Is it Alex?
Yeah.
Which is Alex. From Youth Connect, and they're going to do the presentation, so rather than make them wait through all this other business, we'll get that done early. I think those are the two things, aren't we? So move on to item 1, apologies.
Okay, we received apologies from Councillors Gregory, White and Thatcher.
Thank you.
And everybody else.
Yeah. Okay. Declaration of interest, so members to declare an interest are not currently entered in the member's register of interest, or she is not to notify the Vice-Rossi Officer of receiving a written request for dispensation for disclosure of pecuniary interest and to grant any request for dispensation as appropriate. Any council members want to mention anything? No? Okay. So none on that. So now we're going to move on to the Youth Connect. So we're going to jump to item 6, the report from Youth Connect. We've all received, both a Word document and a PowerPoint giving information about the recent survey that Youth Connect did. And that's the start of the process of then planning the delivery of their services. So I'd like to invite them to
respond. You want to grab the table forward so you sat.
So yeah,
I've got a table grab forward so you can sit on the table.
Yeah, can I connect that to the TV or
you got a USB cable? Have we got a USB cable?
If not, I can.
What's the cable underneath?
What's the black cable?
Or is that
the
rest?
No, that's usual.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. How long is it?
Do you want to sit here?
Yeah, do you mind?
Yeah, whatever.
Thank you.
No.
Sorry, thank you.
Sorry?
Yeah.
Okay.
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 Right.
Okay.
Right. Okay.
Let's hope it just picks up, does it?
I think so.
Oh, it does?
Yeah, it does, yeah.
Oh, dear.
So, yeah, I'll quickly introduce myself. I'm Alex. I am the senior youth worker for North East Somerset. Jane Lewis, programme manager for Youth Connect South West. So, yeah, recently we have started delivering again in Midsummer Norton for youth work. As part of that, we did a consultation questionnaire with the young people. Find out the expectations of us and them. As you can see, we spoke to just over, 153 young people between the ages of 13 and 19. So we asked the young people, that we were speaking to, where's the nearest place that they live. As you can see, 63% of them actually said Midsummer Norton, which is great. We had 28 from Westfield and 29 from 28 from Radstock, 29 from Westfield. Again, we had quite a good even split between male and female participants in the consultation questionnaire. So yeah, we asked the young people, have you ever been to a youth club or a session? 86 said that they regularly attend youth clubs or sessions, so that's in North East Somerset, here, Radstock, Westfield, Poulton, Timsbury. 40 young people said that they had attended youth sessions in the past but no longer go, and 27 said that they'd never been. They gave a number of different reasons why. They've heard negative things, the delivery stopped, they don't know where it is, can't get there, access issues, not welcoming. They're not sure what happens, and it's not at a time that suits them. And that's, mainly information for us as a service to take that feedback on board. We asked the young people what they like to get up to in their spare time. As you can see, sports was the most dominant one. A lot of young people engaging in sports, uniformed groups, not so much detached project, after school clubs, drama groups, none for dance. Gym and exercise was another popular one, music, arts, volunteering and so on. It was quite interesting to see that actually the majority of young people don't do anything outside of school, which for us is very important to know. As a youth service and starting to deliver youth work, getting young people involved in activities or sessions outside of school is, well, it's what we do, that's our bread and butter, essentially. Again, quite an interesting one. So we asked the young people, do you think there's enough for young people to do in your area? 64% of them said no, and 36 yes. Again, goes back to what we do as a youth service is delivering things for young people to engage in positive, meaningful activities, keeping the young people out of trouble, and yeah. So mainly for us, but we spoke to young people and asked them, how are you likely to find out what has been going on? As I'm sure you can imagine, social media and friends was the main hitter. Young people nowadays, social media, online, I think young people spend most of their days, if not in school, online, flicking through social media, and again, talking to their friends. We asked the young people what day is best for youth work delivery. As you can see, Monday being the main day. We are currently delivering two sessions a week in Midsummer Norton, one on a Monday and one on a Friday. So I think, sort of before we put the questionnaire out, we sort of gauge when the best days would be, and luckily from the data it seems like we sort of hit the mark there. But again, ask the young people, what time would you like youth work delivery? Half of them said late evenings. One of our sessions we are delivering 7 till 9 o'clock at night, so sort of hitting the mark on that one. And early evening, our Friday session is right after school, 4 till 6, so we're catching those young people coming out of Norton Hill, coming out of Somerville before they've even been home, and they're wanting to engage in youth work. We had a few for afternoon, and that sort of took into account young people who are what we call as NEET, not in education, employment or training. It was quite interesting to see that they wanted some stuff during the afternoon, and we can provide services for those young people to get involved in. So we asked the young people a series of questions about how they felt in their local area. One of them being, I feel safe. 63% said they sometimes feel safe in the local area. And quite interesting for us and possibly you guys to know how young people actually feel. A good one really, that 54% of young people feel like they are mostly valued members of the community. Which I think is great. I know young people can get a bad reputation, or not necessarily get tarred with the wrong brush, but to know that young people actually feel valued in their community is brilliant in my eyes. Next one was, I know how to get my voice heard. 69% of young people said never, they don't know how to get their voices heard, and that's something that we can help and assist with. Allowing young people to have a voice, giving them a chance to voice their opinions, speak, and put forward what they think should be happening with their lives as such. And the last one, I feel listened to by decision makers. 57% of them said never. And whether that's because, going back to the last one, they don't know how to get their voices heard, they don't know how to get their opinions across. And that's something we can help with. There is another question at the bottom of this one, I'll get to it. So we asked the young people, how would they like youth work delivered in their area? What we were doing during the summer was what we class as detached youth work. That was me and another member of staff walking around different areas of Midsummer Norton, chatting to young people, putting on small sports sessions here and there. No base, we were just out and about. We were in the young people's spaces, engaging with them. And yeah, so none of them actually wanted detached youth work. What we were getting mainly from them is they wanted a safe space in Midsomer in which they could attend, a central hub of some sort. We were quite, as a service, we're quite lucky. We have a mobile youth provision that we use. We might have seen it, it's basically a van kitted out for different types of activities. We've recently been bringing that down since the summer holidays have finished, parking it up at the Soma Centre in the car park by the skate park and engaging in positive, meaningful activities with the young people. And 135 out of 153 said that they would like a safe space in Midsomer Norton and would like to attend some sort of youth cafe if it was possible out of the Soma Centre. So I know there were some ideas floating around of us putting on a youth cafe straight after school for young people to just drop in, say hello, maybe take part in some sort of activity, some issue-based work. And yeah, it's great to see how many young people said that they would attend that sort of session. And yeah, going back to the other questions was to have some more say in your community. Would young people be interested in sessions where, you know, they can help make a positive change to the local community? Again, quite a even 50-50 split, 51% saying yes and 49% saying no, which I think that's a win in my eyes. You know, young people don't really, yeah. I think when you were young, did you really want to come in and, you know, speak to your local councillors and get involved in that sort of thing? Probably not, but just, you know, to see 50-50 split on the young people wanting to make a positive change in the community, I personally think that's great. So yeah, I think that is the lot for the slides. So if any questions, I'd like to try and answer them. Jane?
I don't know, but you could talk, I don't know if you want to talk about what you might do in the leading on from this, what would be the next steps?
Do you want that one or shall I?
We can move to it if you want.
Yeah.
It depends on what the council wants, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Because at the moment we're delivering two sessions. We use the mobile youth bus for one. But to go inside a building costs money because we can't do that with two staff, it's not safe. And we need rents, we need to be able to pay the rent. So the cost of our sessions would increase. But, you know, that's what young people want everywhere. They want a safe space to go. You know,
so previously we were doing that when it was the Unit 14.
Yes.
That was for the games.
And then the mobile. Yeah.
No, we've never.
You had this on the skate park. We had the little storage unit.
The container.
It was sort of, yeah.
That container is no longer fit for purpose. Yeah. So yeah, we jumped ship on that one because it was a bit of a health hazard for the young people.
It seems like a no-brainer to use the summer centre, but I know what you're saying. It costs money to heat it and all of that. Could the money from a cafe?
Because it's a cafe is aimed at young people, often there's no charge.
You can't
make a profit because then you're excluding people who can't afford it.
No, sure, I understand that. I just didn't know if you...
No, it's fine.
Have you a proposal for us as to what could be offered based on, obviously we can analyse and take those in ourselves, obviously it's very clear what the provision that is required. Is there a proposal?
Not at this moment in time, no.
When might there be one?
Well, it depends what we want. That's the point. We can't. We need to know.
So we had the conversation. Lee, Joe, myself, Kate was involved, and Sam and Jane a while ago about what we would want and what could happen, and you know ideas around it, which was just the start of the process. And then the youth clerk went away. Told us what the situation was at that time and went away and did this questionnaire. Now we're at a point of discussing with them, you know, what they feel the need is based on the questionnaire, what we think from our understanding of the town and experience in the town. So what I'd like to do, and I think it was in the notes, was the next stage would be to have another meeting of the small numbers of the deputy mayor himself and the clerk. But taking any information, or any ideas, or any proposals that councillors might have from their day-to-day experience or their thoughts and whatever, take that along, and using this questionnaire and the expertise and experience of Youth Connect to sort of start to think about what we could do. Sam is a plumber who has talked to us before, so we said it should be a dialogue between the two organisations, you know, that what we think is needed or what we'd like to see. So this is me sort of inviting you at this point to, as council, to say this is what I've been told or I found out from my experience that would be good. Can you take this along to the meeting? We'll have a chat. Then the Youth Connect will come back, or I'll come back, we'll submit something to say, but these are the ideas that are around. How do you feel about these? That's the sort of
way. Are we using that information that's just been
given? Well, that's part, yeah, part
well,
of it.
Well, I would interpret that as they need to my own side, particularly in the winter months, to go to. And if they like hanging out down by the skate park, which I imagine is very popular, it seems that that's the closest place. So either we need to work out how much it costs to heat and light that for two evenings a week. Because evenings were better, weren't they?
Yeah.
Evenings
so
or afternoons.
Yeah, so I think you guys had a conversation with Sam about some drop-in sessions after school, which where the youth cafe sort of idea came from. I mean, if the young people want it, one late, one early, straight after school, one later on in the evening, or what, you know, essentially, yeah.
It would be when the budget that we currently
well,
have
there's budget with Summer Valley Rediscovered to run the forest school session, which would be like a cafe, and it would be like a winter cafe, so
yeah,
it would be
yeah.
A
that would be good to know, if different you know, organisations can work together, there's funds that can be you know, taken from different places. Terry, do you want to say something?
Thank you very much for doing this, first of all. Very interesting. Great that you got to speak to so many young people as well. So my question is that obviously towards the end of the survey you gave them a kind of like a very fixed question, if we could provide, would you be interested? And they said yes. I'm just wondering whether there were any other indications to give us perhaps a wider understanding of what young people want in Midsummer North, as opposed to just do you want us to provide a centre? Was there anything else that came out during your discussions with them, which you were capturing in the survey, but which you thought were...
So there were a few questions I left off, and they were mainly sort of for us as a service in terms of feedback and issues that young people are facing these days. Most of these questionnaires were filled out face-to-face, so we did put it online for those that you know may not come out and still want to you know have a say in the youth work. I'd say 95% of these questionnaires were done face to face, and from the young people, they were just more than happy to have youth work back in Midsummer and Autumn. Like I said, twice a week at the moment, we're taking our mobile provision down to the skate park. We're getting you know all right numbers, between 20 and 30 participants each session. That is slowly growing as the word gets out. There wasn't so much, I see what you mean, the questions were pretty rigid because I was sort of going off the idea of that was what was potentially going to happen and being offered, but no, I understand what you're saying. So no, there wasn't really too much leeway in the questions of what other else would the young people want, but that's definitely something we can still speak to the young people about and find out and yeah, see if there is anything else that they would like other than...
I think that was one of the remit of the question was... What service could you provide?
Yeah,
you know, and have that look rather than a wider need. Sure.
Thank you. Yeah. So thank you for the presentation. It'd be interesting to look into this in more detail. I mean, understand more about the demographics because there's a huge difference between a 13-year-old and a 19-year-old, and their needs and their influences.
Yeah.
So it'd be good to have some sort of breakdown in that area. Mm-hmm. We have kids in Midsummer North that are involved in antisocial behaviour and issues, and are we reaching those? And within this survey, where is the demographic of this survey? Are you going to the local school, or these people that are already coming to a youth service, or how are you finding your 153
I'll answer the demographic side of it. So before we started delivering, myself and a staff member, we mapped out Midsummer Norton and sort of surrounding areas. So a lot of the out of town surveys that were completed, we completed at different projects. So Poulton, Timsbury, you know, surrounding areas, Radstock, in which we work. But we were also coming down here, skate park, Riverside. We were just sort of finding the hot spots of where young people sort of hung out. I'd like to think we're probably targeting the group that are most likely to engage in antisocial behaviour. That's making an assumption, but you know, we were hanging around outside of schools, Somerville, Rivlington, Norton Hill, trying to catch as many young people. We probably spoke to a lot more young people, but actually getting a young person to spare 10 minutes of their time to fill out a survey is a little bit harder. Absolutely. Than, yeah.
I'm just thinking that just approaching kids that are outside in a relatively random way, we perhaps could put a little more science behind this and get more detailed data, particularly by talking to the local schools.
Yeah.
I mean, useful to sort of expand on that data.
Yeah.
To get,
yeah, of course.
Because obviously they're looking, ultimately looking to invest money in, and we need to make sure that we're focusing the money we've got in the right direction. The van, what's the capacity of the van that you were talking about? Is it, what size van is it? Is it?
Oh, it is an, it's not 3.5, is it? I don't know, I don't even know the dimensions. It's, or.
It was a it was coach built, so it was a van that the children's services bought and then had it completely rebuilt because they used it in villages and they had couches and all sorts in it.
Okay.
Sorry, and treatment areas. It's got quite, I don't know what the seating capacity is for it.
Safely, I'd say 15 maximum.
Okay.
Plush.
Okay, just a rough idea.
And we've got pop-up gazebos that we use as well when we use the
Is that the map that comes to the fair?
Yes.
So I'm thinking, I mean, certainly for the outskirts, the outlying villages, I think that's a great idea.
Yeah.
I think for Midsummer Norton as a town, I was never too keen on the idea of a storage container. And I think we need to effectively treat young people with the respect they deserve and give them facilities that reflect that.
Yeah.
Not temporary structures or temporary vehicles. So I think I'd like to explore that more.
Yeah.
So the other thing is, Did we look when we did the survey and went something to look at is the existing facilities in the town? Is it, are those facilities not suitable for them or not accessible for them? So things like the sports centre, things like, be, understand whether what we've got in town is just not being able to access it or whether it doesn't suit their needs, rather than reinvent the wheel by creating a facility that already exists.
Yeah.
Finally, the other thing, because obviously we did put £10,000 to aside in our last budget, aimed at not at ongoing costs because that has to be repeated annually.
Yeah.
This was a one-off to invest in equipment and to provide a facility or provide the equipment within a facility that would perhaps suit your needs. But the other thing I was thinking of is that could you not be looking also at sponsorship?
We do all the time.
You do?
We do all the time. We work in, the youth work, all of the youth work apart from Bath is funded by town and parish councils. It's not funded any other way. So in each town and parish, we're always looking for sponsorship and additional funding, which goes towards, sometimes it's staffing, sometimes it's a better programme, sometimes it's use of buildings.
And are the youth services in Midsummer Norton subsidised by any sponsorship?
Not at the moment, they're not, no.
Okay, so there's an area that we should be exploring to see if we could get some of the more community-orientated businesses locally who want to help your youth services to sponsor. And then we genuinely do have the funding to develop something quite interesting for young people. Okay, well, that's fine, thank you.
Can I respond to the ASB question you raised. So I sit on the ASB panels for Baines and Somerset, and also I sit on the PREV, which is the Prevention of Exploitation and Serious Youth Violence. When we get young people come up, we know who they are, we know where they live, that sounds dreadful, And we will target those young people. So, for example, the issues we've had in Midsummer Norton High Street and in the Hollies, the detached team were going in and not dispersing them. That wasn't our aim. But we know these young people and we have relationships with them. And so we were able to provide alternative activities to stop them getting into trouble and to talk about maybe you shouldn't hang around in the Hollies because look, this is what's happening and this is what's happening. So yeah, we're able to do that. And the same with young people who come up at PREF. If we know them in the areas we work in, we'll target them and we'll make sure our support is in place for when they access our provision.
Okay.
And somebody asked that would be to direct them to other existing youth services, not...
Yeah, yeah, because...
You don't have to solve all the problems, do you?
No.
Oh my goodness, no. But for PREV, for example, is a classic example of that. I mean, because that's the point of it. Is there enough support in place for this particular young person? And what agencies are involved? Because we offer targeted support as well, not the youth team. We've got three strands, and the other is alternative education. But the ASB, the police contact us directly when there's hotspots to ask if we've got teams working in those areas.
Okay, thank you very much. Well, I'd like to wrap up because we've got quite a few of the items. If it's really important, if we can...
It's really important. So there's a charity called I Can and I Am, and they've got two double-decker buses that they park at ours, and they, more often than not, sit empty, and they're kitted out as, more often than not, in school holidays, I should say, which is maybe when some of these kids are kicking around more, than not. They're a charity, I'm sure they'd love to help, and they've got, Howdens have given them loads of sponsorship, and they're a local company, so Howdens do a load of sponsorship, but totally on the quiet, which this has now been videoed, so he's a really great guy, I think, their CEO, and looking for stuff to help local people. But also the guy who owns this charity will happily, I mean, it's less than a mile to get it to Summer Centre, and it's kitted out as a kitchen, and you make pizzas on there.
Where are the buses kept?
Welton, on the farm in Welton.
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, it's really doable. And I think it's about £350 for a session, so we could support a few of those sessions to trial it.
But if you could put this down,
we can send the details.
They're actually at my school at the moment.
Yeah, they're really great. Yeah.
I just wanted to bring that all together because there's some really important discussions and there's a really important data that comes from this, and it's some form of shared brief that is potentially brings forward a proposal as a result of this, which is something we've identified. This work is identified as an early midweek or a later week Friday post-school early evening provision for youth services or youth activities in central Midsummer Norton's location. The cost or availability of facilities is yet to be defined, but you know the type of facility that's needed and required, so we can obviously, within a kind of a brief look for that. If obviously you're here and there's a provision or potential provision for us to kind of produce funding, is there something else that can be addressed to link in with that? I.e., the massive part of that was how engaged young people feel. They might feel part of the community, they might feel there's a lot on offer. That can obviously grow, but they feel this engaged. So is there sort of conversation around encouraging the development of a mechanism for that? You know, it could develop towards some kind of youth council, which we can obviously encourage support. And then following on from that, Sean's comment and part of the to say, if there was funding put in, because everyone's, we have to really scrutinise the spending that we have, is there the ability or the provision to attempt match funding to get local businesses to support the same provision that the council would love to put in, or something like that, or would like to, with an identified need for it from this data? So that to me feels a brief for us to work towards.
Cool.
Sustainability. Yeah.
And to be sustainable, so they can potentially run themselves in the future otherwise.
Yeah. Brilliant, going to wrap this. Thank you very much, councillors, for your input. Thank you, Jane.
Cheers, thank you.
We're going to see what
We then go back to item number three, which is public session. So, any members of the public want to say anything this evening? Any burning issues to raise? No, okay, good. So, none being raised. We'll move on to the Mayor's announcements. I've had a very busy summer, but I haven't been to a place I accommodated down the paper over the last few days. So, I did attend the Rugby Club Seniors meeting with my chains on the 28th of September. I had a short meeting with Steve England, who's working with Summer Valley FM, Summer Valley Rediscovered, sorry, on some of their work, so we'll talk about that. So that's discussions I've had, so I've got ongoing with him. I attended the ALCA AGM online AGM last weekend as well. It was important, two interesting things. One, the keynote speech was about youth engagement. So again, a lot of ideas there that feed into discussions. And it gave me an opportunity to thank Barnaby Hardy, who worked with us last year, thank him for his support earlier in the year. I have got several engagements coming up, quite a lot of engagements, building up over the next couple of months, with it being Christmas and all those sorts of things. So I'll keep you forward to those. Any questions for that? Item number five. Sorry,
can I just clarify and ask, please, the public session, does that constitute the body of the public session?
Yes.
Yes, okay.
I've done that. Nobody has said that. Confirm previous minutes. So you've had the minutes of the previous town council meeting. Yeah. Anybody want to make any comment on those? If not, then we'll... so I've got a propose to accept those. Chair was proposing, Linda's seconding, all in favour of accepting the minutes. That's carried.
I'll sign now at the end.
I'll sign at the end. Keep moving. We've done item number six, youth connect. Item number seven, conclusion of the annual review. So again, we've had that information. To notice. The notice of conclusion from the external auditors relating to the financial year 23-24. Any questions about it? Sure.
Sorry, just one question. On section two, so that would be section two, box three. So does this include SILM S106?
Defer to the clerk.
Sorry, so 160,036. That's everything other than precept.
Right.
Everything other than precept.
So is that still in 106, is it?
Yeah, it will be in there, yeah. If you had some, I mean, this is the last financial year, so I'm assuming you must have had some.
Okay.
So a lot of that would be the grant funding for the town hall, wouldn't it?
Well, I'm just clarifying that.
Yeah.
What is that?
Yeah.
Okay,
so it's everything the council received as a number other than the precept.
Okay, all right.
Yeah,
okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
Right. Other questions?
No, that's fine.
That's all you got.
Yeah. So just to clarify.
Nobody else?
Yes. One little question. Why was there a null next to the, I think it's the same thing, but the annual government statement?
Okay, so you should probably ask that.
We didn't provide the proper opportunity for people to exercise.
Okay, so what you've got here is the first five pages are already off the external auditor. Mm-hmm. Page six is the bit that's been returned to complete the document. Yeah, and it actually talks about that. Okay, and in the bottom box, yeah, the smaller authority has confirmed that it has not complied with section one as assertion four, the none. So they've asked why. So the reality with that is that you had a change of clerks and locums last year, and we can provide no evidence to the external auditor that notice was issued. Don't say it wasn't done, but we couldn't supply it. So normally you take a screenshot of the web page or a photograph of the notice board.
Yeah.
Okay, so people think it was done, but there's no evidence that it was done, and that's to inspect the accounts. That should be done between sort of a 4-week window between 15th of July and the 31st of August, slide. So we couldn't confirm that. So we wrote to the external auditor and said, actually there was a change of personnel, whilst we believe it was undertaken, because people have some memory of it, we can provide no evidence for it, and it will happen.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's just the transition of...
This is going last year, because we've just finished our...
Yes, this year's been done. This is from about July 23. Yeah. So normally, when they ask for evidence, you send them out to the screenshots on the website to say, because obviously it gets deleted after 6 weeks. Yeah. So that was that point there.
Thanks.
Yep.
Good. There's no further questions, and we just noted that. Yeah. Good. So we move on to item eight, nominations for the Civic Awards. So you've got some information there. the proposal is to defer the annual civic awards until May or around that time next year, held as part of the annual meeting due to the low number of nominations received. So you can see there that what those only nominations in sports achievement and lifetime achievement. I did ask the clerk for a clarification, and Joe has done a lot of work on this in providing information, the background on it. It could be relaunched more widely over the next couple of weeks and try and encourage more engagement with this. That is one option, to go for the date that we've got, that we've set. But the main proposal is that we postpone it and have it as a joint event with the annual town meeting. Yeah. And at that time, fingers crossed, touching wood, the town hall will be well and surely open.
Yeah,
and so we're
going
to have a good opportunity to have the event there, Gordon.
Yeah, I think that's the idea. I think that was part of the plan. It was definitely written down at some point. The plan was to try and have the AGM with the Civic Awards to create more of a big event.
Yeah.
It's more likely to get people together for one big event than having two disparate events. Yeah. Might be less work. And for whatever reason, we didn't do that last year. So I think now that the fact the options are again, we should seriously consider it. And if we are going to consider it, which we should start thinking about publicising it a bit more heavily than we did existing Civic Awards.
Yeah.
So,
okay. Anybody else got any comments or opinions?
But this is a decision, is it?
It's the decision, yeah, the proposal is to postpone it to the town.
I would be happy to propose that.
So you're proposing. Charles can second it, right? So all in favour of postponing the advertising. Okay, well, that's carried unanimously. Ms. Musley. Thank you very much.
Fairly proposed. It was a council word.
Charles seconded.
Anybody was in favour?
Yeah, was in favour, yeah. Item number 9 is transfer of funds from the CCLA account. There's a vote required here. It's to consider transfer of general reserves from the CCLA account into the Unity Trust, Unity Bank Trust. The recommended amount is £100,000. So the proposal is to accept the recommendations to transfer the funds to Unity Trust Bank. Do we have it? Sure.
So this is just a very temporary adjustments until the preset payments?
No. So we have in the CCLA, in the amount reserved, some several hundred thousand pounds. It's just about to transfer it from one account to the current bank account.
Yeah, and but the report would indicate that that's because we're waiting for the preset payment.
We've had the preset payment. We've just had it.
So why do you need the 100,000 from the CCLA?
Well, because we're expecting some large bills through over the next month or two.
Right, so let's be clear, are you taking money out of the CCLA as payments for Town Hall that aren't covered by the existing funding?
No, it's covered, it's just in a different account, so it's about the physical transfer of the money. So the council has...
Okay, but you're not being clear in the report why you need the 100,000. The report would indicate that you are waiting for a precept payment, 279,000,
yeah.
And in the interim, to make sure that your bills are paid on time, you were going to borrow 100,000 from the CCLA, and I would have assumed from that you were going to put it back in. That's not what, so the report's misleading.
No, so it's about cash flow.
Right, so we're taking money out of reserves to pay bills because we're short in our...
No, so it's not average, so it's allocated money. This is a savings account, not the current account. So we're just moving it from the current savings account to the current account.
So is this money part of public works loan money?
Yes, I guess. But not, I mean, we don't split the money, so all the money goes into...
Well, it's quite an important question. Understand the funding, whether...
Yeah. So the money you have, okay, is a combination of the precepts, the public works loan boards, and the balance that's left from last year.
Yeah.
Okay?
Okay.
So what we do with that large sum of money, to leave in the current account, yeah, where it earns no interest, okay, we transfer it to the CCLA.
I understand what
you're saying. What we're saying is we're getting relatively low on funding, so we want to draw down £100,000 of that, so we have some money for the next 2 months to pay that, and then in probably 2 months we'll have some more. So it's just about having that money coming to bank account to pay the recurring bills. And I think this month's bill from the contractor is something like £60,000. Mm. So only having £200,000 in the bank isn't a lot, and we'll have another one in 3 weeks' time, 4 weeks' time. So just okay. It's just moving the money into the current account to pay bills that are due in the next.
Okay. Well, in future, would it be useful if we had a full report, including showing us where that leaves us in terms of our reserves and legal obligations on reserves. So it would be useful if the report was actually a full report, if that makes sense.
Okay, thank you, Tim.
I was just going to say, my interpretation of that report is that the money could run out at any point, and it's a little bit of a logistical nightmare to transfer money, as someone that's involved with the process of approving payments and seeing how much money actually comes in and out every month. If there was ever the instance that the precept was late, as it is this time, it's good to hold a float so we can keep council business running. Yeah. And this is a determined figure that is respectable for doing that, and I'd make a proposal in mind with the report for that reason.
So we both interpreted it differently, which is why you're saying it needs clarification.
I mean, I'm not going to comment on how you interpreted it, but I interpreted it as such, and I'd like to make the proposal.
So you're making a proposal. Do we have a seconder for the proposal? And then Linda's seconding. So all in favour of the proposal to transfer the funds? That's carried unanimously. Thank you, everybody. Item number 10 is cancelled, as we've not received any formal correspondence about the matter. So at this point in time, the Town Trust lease for the Solar Centre, we're skipping item.
We're under the impression that we might be asked for the money.
Yes, I'm not sure we're going to be specific. No, Okay,
that's fine. So we'll move on to item 11. Again, Per has been asked to vote here to consider the approval and adoption of the updated Town Council CCTV policy. I've been told that the Town Clerk has been able to find an existing CCTV policy. So this one has been put together, has been presented to us, and satisfies the necessary requirements. So that is what we've been asked to vote on, that we adopt this CCTV policy, as we don't have one.
One question. Should the trusts have a similar policy, perhaps, as well? So the council's going to have a CCTV policy. Quite a lot of the land in question.
Who's the CCTV?
Well, it's a good question. So, for instance, the Town Trust recently purchased a surveillance camera, which they use in a mobile way to do surveillance of Town Trust properties. So
I would suggest the Town Trust contact the ICO and ask them if they're required.
Yeah, okay.
But I know that the Town Council has CCTV, and the ICO requires us to have a policy. Just an overarching policy about what we generally use it for.
Yeah. Yeah. So we should probably have the same.
You should probably have a conversation with the ICO. I can help out the Town Trust if you like, to contact the right people.
Because obviously, there's a Summer Centre as well, so currency. Yeah. They're not direct accountability, obviously, we have to make sure that we're all doing it correctly.
Yeah. But I'm only concerned about the council being compliant for its CCTV, the problems other organisations that are loosely attached to us.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's a matter for them to.
Right.
Any questions? Comments? Sure.
So, are we saying that we've taken an old policy and adapted it, or we say there wasn't a policy and there now is?
Right, I couldn't find one. I'm sure there must have been somewhere, but I've only been posted 3 months and looking through the files. We can't find one that existed. Okay, I'm sure there probably was one, okay, but it's not. So the safest bet was for me was to produce a new one that was compliant with the ICO, just in case somebody asks. It was the easiest way to solve that situation.
So, for no further question, I propose that we accept the recommendation, or not this, I propose that we accept the policy, the CCTV policy, and we adopt that. Any seconder? Yeah, Cheryl's seconding. All in favour of adopting the policy? It's carried unanimously. Thank you very much. Let's skip to item number 12, relationship between the Town Council and the Trusts. So this item, to provide an introduction to the relationships and obligations that the Town Council has with the Midsummer Norton Community Trust, the Midsummer Norton Town Trust and the Recreation Trust. So there's quite a document here that goes in some detail, explain that. This is the beginning of trying to establish clearly the relationships between these organisations. There's a recommendation at the end of series of recommendations, but the main recommendation is to set up a workshop or a working group of all councillors to have a dialogue about this information rather than I think, get into a long discussion about it now, but so we've not been asked to accept anything, but to take this as a discussion document and to convene at some point and understand this. So it's discussed and begin to understand the issues presented in the report, review the available guidance and legislation, understand the benefits of partnership working with local charitable trusts, and to understand the relationship and responsibilities with charities where the council is self-trustee. Is there any comments about the document, Sean?
Generally, I'm happy with it. Paragraph 11 is lacking the Charity Commission guidance that came out in August the 8th, which seems to be as a result of actually these the issues that they're seeing between organisations and charities. And it actually, the Charities Commission actually listed within that document a whole list of issues and areas of concern and areas that we should be looking to address. I will send you a link to it. Yeah. But I think we need to include the Charity Commission guidance in that.
I'm sure there'll be more as well.
Yeah.
So I'll speak to you and make sure we've got the right.
Okay.
Any other comments? Cheryl?
Yeah, just want to say thank you very much for presenting a report that actually starts to untangle things, provides some very clear areas as to what we need to take account of, things that might need further discussion and untangling. I think we call it unpicking where I work. So thank you very much indeed. And if nobody else wants to make any comments, I'd like to propose that we accept all the recommendations.
Can I just ask, I can't see any time frames on this.
No, so when you make a decision, what I think we would do, because if you didn't want to talk about it, I wouldn't make time.
Oh, okay.
I'll then say to councillors, oh, we spoke about it, is there a time you want to talk about it? You know, over the next 2 weeks, 4 weeks, 6 weeks, to get some, and dial some time. And we can do that either by a gathering in person, or by Teams, or hybrid. Okay? So if you can agree to move forward, then I'll just try and find a good time for everybody.
Mm-hmm. So just, focusing on...
I'd second that.
Yeah. So the proposal to have convene a workshop working group with all councillors, okay?
Yeah.
All in favour?
Yeah.
Everybody's in favour again.
So I didn't propose that.
You're doing well. Cheryl, seconded by Tim. So that's item 12 and item 13. Is the from the Town Trust Management Committee to note the resignation of Councillor Deborah Thatcher from the Town Trust Committee and receive an update from the Town Trust. So Lee has finished handing out this letter from the Town Trust. There's one item that we've been asked to vote on, and that is the...
That's two, actually.
Is it two? All right, you can put me right on this. So,
one's to replace Councillor Thatcher's recent resigns.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so the Constitution probably says four councillors, or up to four councillors. So to nominate a councillor to fill that space, you don't have to, but obviously yes, you should do. And the other question is, I went to a Town Trust meeting last Monday, that's why you didn't get this agenda, because the meeting only happened last Monday night, and they were of the view that they would like to expand the management to include members of the public, the management committee, and they've asked us to expand the membership to be four councillors and up to four members of the public. Yeah, and even as a gentleman who turned up to the meeting, he was keen to get involved. So they're asking for two things: replace Councillor Thatcher as a volunteer, and then expand that working group, sorry, that management committee to in fact eight people, so four councillors and up to four members of the public. The reason go to four members of the public is so the members of the public don't outweigh the council. Yeah. I think they thought it would be a good way of getting more people involved, and the more people are involved than non-councillors, then the chances of percolating good news out to other interested groups might be better.
Okay. So the first item, nominate a councillor. It's Councillor Tumbalas amendment, and Gordon Mackay and Linda Robertson. So, is anybody else want to put themselves forward.
Can I do a further introduction on that, for what they said? Essentially, the Town Trust has, once we've got into it, we've sort of found that there's work to be done in terms of its sustainability long term, I would say is the right word. And there's a lot of progress already made on that towards it, and it's quite an exciting time to be involved with the Town Trust, because just from a council's perspective, as the main sole trustee effectively, and the management committee can actually act and do, as opposed to the role we occupy as councillors as such. So it's an interesting thing to be part of for both councillors and anyone else who wishes to get involved with the Town Trust, as we've had one person step forward to do, so it can actually do, which is the great thing like the Community Trust does as well. Where we make decisions here that have action as a result, there we can do.
Any volunteers?
I'd have to go on.
Oh, brilliant.
Right.
Yeah. I could swap my hats.
If you get stuck, I'm happy to do it as well.
Well, Cheryl's nominated herself. Do you want to vote on Cheryl, or do you want to go?
No, that's fine.
You guys want to discuss it.
Okay, so Cheryl's proposed herself for nomination. Does anyone want to second?
Yeah.
Linda's second. Right, so we vote on Cheryl becoming a member of the Town Trust Management Committee. All in favour?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's carried unanimously.
Well, then anyone can see you obstructed for Sean's up on one of the trusts, because that'd be a good thing.
I know.
So we do have a police and another one.
Sorry, yes.
Well,
I'm
not a member of the public.
Well,
right.
Do I have to notify you for a change in the Register of Interests now?
Sorry?
Do I have to notify a change in the Register of Interests?
No.
Just to clarify, I can attend the meetings anyway.
Yeah.
So,
it's a management committee meeting, they're not public meetings.
Well, I thought the entire Town Council were trustees.
No. So the council or corporate body is a trustee.
Okay.
Yeah. So the management committee manages on behalf of the trustees, which is everybody, every councillor. So you're not an individual member. Okay, you're the councillors. And they manage it in line with the aims of the council. They should report to you each year. And if you like what they do, you say carry on. If you don't know what they do, you go, we'll change the committee. And you can't do A, B, and C. So you should. We had a chat about it on Monday. The minutes of the meeting from Monday haven't quite been finished. Actually, they landed on my desk about 3 o'clock this afternoon. So the next meeting, they'll be brought to this council. Yeah, and you can monitor their activity, their day-to-day activity, through that. And if you don't like something, then you can send a message back to them and say, as agreed by the council, that you don't like something or you do like something.
But could you not join as a member of the public, though? Hey? Are there four members of the public, or not?
Well,
I just wondered that's how I understood it.
You haven't voted at the moment to have four members of the public, have you? You only vote the councillor.
Right, okay. So but that, well, what we're saying is we're going to have four.
Yes.
Well, we're voting on that.
Yes.
Yeah.
We've also had a proposal at 10.
And then Sean could then join.
Well, then Sean goes
there. Yeah. Well, can you say there's not those rules? I don't understand this relationship between us as a town council, the trustees, and the trust themselves.
We're going to have a workshop. The previous item was to explain that to everybody.
Yeah, because I thought this was in the report as well, but when I read through it, that's how I got the understanding from it.
Yeah, so the previous item was about a workshop, because I've given you some information about it. And then we can sit around as a group of individuals to understand the legislation and the relationship.
Yeah, but you're talking about legislation, that we need to separate between legislation and our own internal set of rules.
Yeah, I'm not sure what your point is, Councillor.
Well, on number of seats and the allocations, etc., for the trusts, for the trustees.
Okay, so the...
And access to meetings.
Okay, so the trust deeds, or the Articles of Association, so there should be up to four councillors, yeah, and it should encourage, I'm not encourage the wrong words, it's in the document there, and to include, it doesn't use lay people, members of the public, I think it's a term it uses, yeah, to be on that management committee, yeah, but as defined by the council.
Exactly. So,
yeah?
So
the council currently says, for the terms of reference currently say four members of the council. The question here is, yeah, so the council can define its membership. Yeah, and it's previously defined as four members of the council. the management committee is saying they would be aided, they think, if that management committee was expanded to four. To include four members of the public.
Okay.
Can I just comment as well, Sean, to kind of try and help out, because I probably didn't elaborate enough on that, the members of the public, so there's more talking to councillors in that respect. But when we sort of come on to the discussion around four members of the public, is that we have users, community groups, lots of other people that are involved with the use of the town trust assets. And the idea was that there are people who can contribute over and above what councillors can, in the interest of course, the councillors, the trustee, to running and contributing to the management of that trust in the interest of the people that use it.
I understand that.
Which is why we proposed the extra people.
That's fine, I understand that. That wasn't the question, but I understand that.
Okay.
So thank you for clarifying that. That's fine.
No,
we'll go to the Articles of Association and the document.
Yeah, and I provided them with the previous item. Yeah, and then that previous item was about, here's some information, look at paragraph 12 of that, it says this list isn't exhaustive, and we should need the first legislation. So the previous agenda item was setting up some learning for councillors about how they operate. So should we do for that form then?
Yeah, as I say, it's just breaking down.
Yeah.
There's a difference between legislation and the Articles Association and our own internal rules and our own requirements. And it's breaking that down and understanding.
Yeah, and that's exactly why I wanted that workshop, to explain to people, when we'll get in a room, ask the questions, I will give you the best advice, or if I haven't got the best advice, I will look to have that best advice. And if we can't agree a situation, we'll get solicitor in and say, please, So just before we engage in a heavy duty process, let's just see if between us we can understand that the subtleties are.
That's right. I want to come back one thing as well, is that perhaps the council should meet slightly more frequently as the trustee, which it can do, which includes all councillors. So all councillors, as part of the council, make up the body of the trustee, and typically we used to have slightly more meetings, and that means all town councillors will be able to make sure that they're happy with what is happening with the trustee, like, because the council is the sole trustee.
Forgive me, I think you're talking about the issues that we want to iron out, which the previous agenda item set up the working group workshop to thrash out. So there's misunderstanding, some words are very particular to charities, and then the use of them is different in general language. So it's about, it says this, I've called them Articles Association, not called Articles Association. So we're about clarity about the terminology involves sole trustee. So,
all this will come out in the discussion we're going to
have. We might have that put in,
innit? The item here is to approve the change in the terms of reference to enable members of the public, all members of the public, to join the Town Trust Management Committee. So,
if you want to put it in place,
Right, so we're proposing, so we're just proposing, Gordon seconding, and those in favour of change in terms of reference, that's a unanimous one as well. Good. Item number 14, to note the reports from the following committees. So the Finance and Ops Committee, the minutes are included in there. I haven't anything further to add, but I'll answer any questions about the F&O meeting if anybody has any of us any issues there? No. Right, moving on to the Staffing Committee. The Staffing Committee minutes. Everyone okay to?
I have a question on the Staffing Committee. The time it was put to doing this is a lot, and I really appreciate that being done towards the specifically towards the recruitment of the new town clerk. I just wanted to know the rationale behind the selection of the interview panel, I just wanted to know the rationale behind it, because I would have thought that the mayor or the vice mayor, vice chair, would be on to that. I'm a bit confused, that's all.
Confused? What way?
How the panel was selected, effectively, because last time we had this process done, it was the mayor, I think, Gordon, you're heavily involved with that recruitment process.
Okay.
As such.
Okay, well, it was decided that the chair and deputy chair of the committee should be on the panel. and then we chose Wendy as a third member.
Okay. What was the recommendation?
Well, the recommendation was the chair and the deputy chair and Wendy.
I think it would be good probably to include either the chair or deputy chair on that panel. I think that would normally be the convention, wouldn't it? Because the standing committee, obviously the standing committee, I'd expect the chair or
just
chair.
Just claim the council rather than of the
committee. I'd expect that. Or maybe that could be the additional member of the panel or to place them on it. But I'd expect one of those people to be on board.
Chair?
Yeah, I don't know whether it's any help because I've been to several interviews over the last few years as a prospective town clerk, and there's always been the chair or the mayor of the council on the interview panels. Always.
Anybody else?
Doesn't really bother me who sits on it, but if we have a staffing committee, I would think that that's their purpose as well, partly. That's my thinking about having a committee.
But yeah, I don't think there's any, passionate about it. Doesn't seem to be any disagreement about who's running the recruitment.
No, but you would think they would then be on the
responsible.
Yeah.
But in the past, I think the mayor or the chair has been on the staffing committee.
Yes.
Yeah, it just feels that it should be representative of the council, and obviously the leader of the council is the mayor, or in his absence, your absence, his or her absence, the deputy mayor would sit in on that, and it just concerned me whether that was considered and what the recommendation might be, and I personally might propose that is taken into account and added to the committee, to the panel.
Yeah, I'd second that.
Yeah.
So what's the pleasure? Do you add to that?
So, well, first of all, do you want to be on it, Martin? Well, I mean, you were the chair of the previous...
I can see the point, and it does seem straight to the chair, whoever it is at the time of the interview process, that is going to work with the new clerk isn't on the staff, which is introduced them and involved in some way of making decisions. So I can see Tim and other people's points of view. So, yeah, I'm happy to come along to... and you'll be part of that process. Appointing the new clerk and matching the applications. Yeah, so I'm happy to do that. If there's a proposal there that whoever the mayor is, and at the moment it's me.
Can I ask what, Lee, as the town clerk, what your recommendation might be in the circumstances? Because it's a panel three or panel four, it matters not. But essentially.
Can I suggest that we take this into confidential session? We'll talk about staffing matters. Yeah, the process. Yeah, so can we defer the matter until the end? Move into confidential session?
Okay.
Yeah.
Right, so let's move on from that.
Are you content with that?
Yeah. I don't know. Everyone happy with that?
Yeah.
You can move on.
I'll explain that.
Okay. The other report is from the Planning Commission, the Planning Committee. If there's no comments on the Planning Committee, minutes, then there's a recommendation that the amended terms of reference were adopted and approved. I've got those, but does anybody, oh it's there, right, terms of reference, I'm looking at it.
Yeah, so the Planning Committee, you're the chair of the Planning
Committee, isn't it? Yeah, no, sure, so that's the change the terms of reference. We've just been asked to sort of ratify them or agreeing. So,
yeah, committee terms of reference must be approved by the council.
Yeah. So, do we have somebody to propose the change to the terms of reference for the captain? Gordon, does anybody second? Chair will second. All in favour? Right. So, it was Gordon proposing. Chair will second. Was it?
Okay.
Everybody. So that's item 14. Item number 15, reports from councillors representing outside bodies. I haven't anything. Does anybody else have any thing they want to share?
Go on. Trust has been busy.
Yeah.
Christmas as well on the week.
There
are definitely lots of plans for Christmas. It looks like more people might be joining for Christmas than we thought. There has been a suggestion in the circles that maybe the town council might have support the community trust, they may be closing the road, for instance, for Christmas. That's not gone forward officially, but that's been discussed. And so the problem with that, so that might be something council might look at. The community trust also was at the farmers market on Saturday for another full session, and I fully recommend the council that making a regular commitment might want to consider coming back to market a few times, because with all this engagement going on, especially if Baines get involved, maybe the town council might be there with the town council staff. So it's not just community trust, people getting involved with me.
Yeah. No, I think in light of what we were talking about earlier with the regeneration project, further engagement.
It's stall at the Christmas market.
Yeah.
And I believe that there's been requests gone out to stall traders and all the rest of the Christmas market, which has been well received. So.
That's good. So any other questions? No? Okay. And final piece of business is the date of the next meeting, the next full council meeting. So it will be held on Monday the 4th of November at 7 PM.
Okay. And that's there is one item now, okay?
There's one item.
Which you'll need to exclude the press and public to the visit the matter of the recruitment.
Yeah.
Okay. Or the start of the business.
So we need to that.
Yeah, about to go into confidential session.
Propose that we go into confidential session to discuss the final speaking chair and second in. All in favour of confidential session to discuss the final thing? Yeah, we all, I believe. So thank you very much for coming.
Sorry, folks.
Oh, is that
camera?